we are here to learn about her journey on the board, as well as what is her advice to women to want to be aspiring board members. How should they plan for their journey? So my first question to you, Devyani, is that the figures look good. Last 5 years we made significant progress, and thanks to the company's actually. From 5% we are now at 30%. But we far still very underrepresented as compared to countries like Norway, who are at 39% women representation. So what do you think organizations or let's say SEBI should do, or or boards themselves should do so that we can get these numbers higher? What should the next mean for us?
I think the biggest transformation itself needs to come from the women first. There has to be a much higher confidence in ourselves, in our ability to make a difference in the boards. There has to be a much higher hunger to want to take that seat.
Right.
And there has to be a much lower tolerance for status quo. We have to make it very clear that we are not okay with the current status. I honestly believe that the day women start standing up together and start saying that this is not okay, and I can add just as much value, if not more, than the other person, boards, companies will listen or will be forced to listen. This cannot be regulated to the extent we want it to be. It cannot be.
Right.
Regulation has done its bit. One, for all of us who've got that seat on the board, I've got my seat on Yes Bank and the Cisco India board. The onus is on us to ensure that we really deliver value. And we conduct ourselves with the professionalism, with the right level of responsibility, etc. That will make the companies and boards realize that there is tremendous benefit in having more women. So the one, the onus is on us to do that. Second, the onus is on the rest of the women to put their hand up and say, we really want to get there. And third, I think the onus is also on the companies to realize that times are changing. Their consumers, who they depend on for their business, are becoming largely women. Today you look at any industry, women are deciding what to buy and what not to buy. We need more women across all levels, whether it's sales, marketing, product development, R&D, and boards. And they have to realize that this is a business decision, and not meeting the requirement of the companies nor diversity.
Just a tick mark on tokenism. I want more women on boards. Whether it is at a corporate level, at a not-for-profit level, even startups for that matter. And we're creating this network of women leaders who are aspiring to be on the boards 3 years down the line. So where do you think they should start while we're trying our best to connect with the right networks? Where do you think person who wants to be in the board, let's say 3 years down the line, what is it that she needs to do now and do the next 3 years so that she can be visible and could be a possible entrant on the board?
Yeah. So first of all, I think kudos to you guys, for creating this kind of a platform, which didn't exist a few years back. Platforms like you didn't exist. So the BD platform, the work that you guys are doing to give a credible platform to women is fantastic. I think what is needed is for women to leverage such opportunities fully. The first thing, if you want a position in the board, you have to put your hand up and let people know. There are so many women who have aspirations but do not talk about it. And it's not just board. It's about wanting my manager's job, wanting a better pay. Somehow, in India, we're still stuck in that mindset that if we are ambitious and we talk about our ambitions, it makes us bad.
You don't like
the bad girls or whatever. It takes us away from our that perception of that perfect, nice Indian woman, right? There's no such thing as a perfect, nice Indian woman. We're all normal human beings. I think the first thing is you have to speak up. You have to ensure people know. There are platforms platforms like BD and others, which actually build a list of women who have the potential to get on boards. Get yourself on one of these platforms. Make sure that people know. See, when boards hire women or companies hire women for their boards, they want a woman who has a good body of work. And therefore, visibility is so important. Not only do you have to have a good body of work, but in most cases, the work will not speak just for itself. You have to speak for your work.
Which is again what women don't do usually.
Absolutely. So you have, if you want, if you have the aspirations to get on a board, you have to do good work, you have to build that body of work, you have to ensure it's visible, you are visible, and you have to demonstrate what value you bring. Nobody reads minds. And no one's going to work that hard to figure out, oh, there must be someone out there who can do this for you, right? People are looking at the networks, and so get onto one of these networks. This is when some of the traits that we women have, and yes, women behave differently from men. We are not men. Okay. People should not expect me to. When people say behave like a man, no, I am a woman. I will behave like a woman. And there are traits that we have, which I think sets us up for success in this kind of an environment. It's sort of hardwired into us, dealing with chaos, dealing with change. Change of plans, dealing with turmoil, it's hardwired into us. You'll be surprised that women actually react to these things in a much more calm and logical manner than sometimes men do. And I can't generalize, I hate generalizing, but this is just what I've seen.
So what are your plans apart from being on the two boards that you've already been a part of?
So this is what I call my learning phase. Everyone has to reinvent themselves, right? I'm giving myself the luxury to reinvent myself. After having worked in the corporate world for 2 decades plus, I think I absolutely owe myself that. My last 5 years since I came back to India, what I realized is there are things that are tremendously exciting, that have the potential to change the world, and that I don't know enough about, and that was not good enough for me. So for me, I had to figure out the time and space to go and do more in those areas. First one was just India itself. I am not just amazed by this country. I love this country. There's something about it, right? Which it gives me goosebumps to even just sit and think about this thing called India, right? There is so much that can be done in this country, and technology plays a huge role. So I want to figure out how I can play a much higher role than what I used to play earlier in enabling some of those transformations. And I think that can be done through collaborations. That can be done by enabling or mentoring or helping segments, groups, people, companies that are in a position to make that difference. And that's the enabler role that I really want to play. So whether it's boards, whether it's becoming a mentor to startups or women, I'm looking at who are the change agents, who can do the most to make a difference, and what role can I play to enable that. Right. That's it's giving me tremendous learning. I call it learning on steroids. The amount I have learned in just the last 1 month. Somebody called it a portfolio career. I love that. Pick the things I really want to do where I have the maximum learning opportunity and where I can contribute the most.
Thank you so much for your time, Devjani. It's been wonderful talking to you. And we at BD Foundation look forward to your guidance. And we look forward to working.
You guys are doing awesome work, so anything I can do to help, absolutely.